सो हेलो एवरीवन एंड वेलकम बैक वंस अगेन टू द सेशन ऑफ गवर्नमेंट स्कीम्स। मैं हूं मनीष मिश्रा एंड गाइस इन टुडे सेशन आई विल ब्रिंग टू यू अ वेरी यूनिक इनिशिएटिव ऑफ द गवर्नमेंट ऑफ इंडिया। दिस स्कीम गाइस हैज बीन वाज लॉन्च बाय द मिनिस्ट्री ऑफ कम्युनिकेशन एंड यस आई एम सेइंग इट यूनिक बिकॉज थ्रू दिस स्कीम द गवर्नमेंट इज प्रमोटिंग अ हॉबी। ऑलराइट, यस यू हैव हर्ड इट करेक्टली, द गवर्नमेंट इज प्रमोटिंग अ हॉबी। So we will discuss about this scheme and the name of the scheme guys is what? Deen Dayal Sparsh Yojana. Alright, Deen Dayal Sparsh Yojana is the name of the scheme and Sparsh has a full form also, Scholarship for Promotion of Aptitude and Research in Stamps as a Hobby. Okay, so the government is promoting collection of stamps as a hobby through this scheme or through this initiative. But before we begin, do subscribe to our channel and press this bell icon, and also you can join this Telegram group for daily quizzes and updated information about the daily sessions. Alright, so let's begin with the session guys, and let us first try to simplify the objective of the schemes. And these are the things guys that you can do effortlessly, jisko aapko dubara se padhne ki zarurat nahi hai. So as I told you, just focus on the full form of the scheme. What is the full form? Scholarship for promotion of aptitude and research in stamps as a hobby. Alright, so there are two important words, stamps and hobby. I hope guys the objective is clear because the full form says it all. Stamps, which means collection of stamps is known as philately, and hobby मतलब कि हम जो philately है, the government जो है वो philately को as a hobby promote करना चाहती है. And why government is doing this? What benefit will it provide to the students? So guys, philately has a lot of educational benefits, like students will get to know about the socio-economic and political aspects of the period for which the stamps is issued. मतलब काफी सारे सोशल इकोनॉमिक और पॉलिटिकल बेनिफिट्स हो सकते हैं इसके. दूसरा, जिस थीम पे वो स्टैम्प इशू किया गया है उसके बारे में भी स्टूडेंट्स को जानने के लिए मिल सकता है. सो इट कैन प्रोवाइड अ लॉट ऑफ बेनिफिट्स टू द स्टूडेंट्स. सो आई होप द ऑब्जेक्टिव इज क्लियर. द गवर्नमेंट इज प्रमोटिंग फिलैटली एज अ हॉबी एंड दे आर ऑल्सो प्रोवाइडिंग स्कॉलरशिप फॉर प्रमोशन ऑफ इट्स रिसर्च. ओके, ताकि स्टूडेंट्स को एजुकेशनल बेनिफिट्स मिल सके थ्रू देयर हॉबी ओनली. ओके, सो दैट इज द ऑब्जेक्टिव गाइज, एंड आई होप the ministry is very much clear since we are talking about the collection of stamps. So the ministry should be Ministry of Communications and Information Technology, and the implementing agency should be India Post, because jo India Post hai wo directly related hai kisse, stamps se. Okay, so these are the ministries and the implementing agency. I hope ki aapko dobara se padhne ki zarurat nahi padegi, and if you remember the full form of this scheme then also the objective aapko dobara se padhne ki zarurat nahi padni chahiye. Okay, and talking about the eligibility, so guys in the eligibility section you just have to remember only one thing, that this scheme is for the students for standard class starting from class 6 to class 9th. Okay, ye keval class 6 se leke class 9th tak ke students ke liye hai, and the student should be from a recognized school within India. Theek hai, and the concerned school should have a philately club and the candidate should be a member of that club. Okay, जो स्टूडेंट है वो एक रिकॉग्नाइज स्कूल से होना चाहिए एंड उस स्कूल में भी फिलैटली क्लब होना चाहिए, एंड दैट स्टूडेंट शुड बी द मेंबर ऑफ दैट क्लब. ओके, एंड इन द रीसेंट फाइनल एग्जामिनेशन द स्टूडेंट मस्ट हैव सिक्योर्ड एटलीस्ट 60% मार्क्स. ओके, 60% मार्क्स उसके कम से कम होने चाहिए, एंड देयर इज अ रिलैक्सेशन ऑफ 5% फॉर SC और ST स्टूडेंट्स. ऑलराइट, एंड दीज टू गाइज यू डोंट हैव टू रिमेंबर, जस्ट रिमेंबर दिस स्कीम इज फॉर द स्टूडेंट्स फ्रॉम क्लास 6 टू क्लास 9th. ओके, एंड rest of the things you don't have to remember, that will not be asked in your exams. And talking about the selection procedure, also selection procedure you don't have to remember, this is just for the basic understanding that how government is providing scholarship, how government is promoting this scheme. So the selection is guys based on the evaluation of project, which is based on the philately and performance in philately quiz that is conducted by the selected circles. Okay, सो बेसिकली जो सिलेक्शन होगा वो प्रोजेक्ट वर्क के इवैल्यूएशन के बेस पे होगा, एंड देयर इज अ क्विज आल्सो जो कि कंडक्ट कराई जाती है थ्रू द सर्कल्स, उनके बेस पे स्कॉलरशिप दी जाएगी, एंड देयर विल बी 920 स्कॉलरशिप दैट इज बीइंग प्रोवाइडेड थ्रू दिस स्कीम. एंड अ कमिटी कंस्टिट्यूटेड एट द सर्कल लेवल कंसिस्टिंग ऑफ पोस्टल ऑफिशियल्स एंड रेनोट फिलेटलीज वुड इवैल्यूएट द प्रोजेक्ट वर्क. ओके, सो दिस इज द सिलेक्शन प्रोसीजर थ्रू विच द गवर्नमेंट इज प्रोवाइडिंग स्कॉलरशिप on promoting philately as a hobby. All right, and now there are only three things that you have to remember guys, only three things. So till now we are done with the objective, which is collecting stamps as a hobby, then the ministry and the implementing agency, then we are done with eligibility. Just remember this is for the class, this is for the students from class 6 to 9, then सिलेक्शन प्रोसीजर दैट इज ऑल्सो यू डोंट हैव टू रिमेंबर, जस्ट यू नो अंडरस्टैंड दिस दैट दिस इज द सिलेक्शन प्रोसीजर. ओके एंड नाउ दीज आर द थिंग्स दैट यू हैव टू रिमेंबर. सो टोटल 920 स्कॉलरशिप विल बी अवॉर्डेड थ्रू दिस स्कीम एंड every postal circle will select a maximum of 40 scholarship representing 10 students each from class 6 7th 8th and 9th. okay, amount of scholarship is how much? Rupees 6000 per annum at rupees 500 per month, and it was launched in the year 2017. So these are the just three things that you have to remember. Launch year 2017, the amount of scholarship is rupees 6000 per annum at the rupees 50 per month. Then we have number of scholarship, that is 920. okay. So guys, that's it about the scheme. I hope the scheme is clear. And now let me summarize the scheme once again. So the scheme Deen Dayal Sparsh Yojana was launched by Ministry of Communication in the year 2017 to promote philately as a hobby, so that the students can get educational benefits by collecting stamps, and by they will be able to know about the socio-economic and political aspects of the period from when the stamp is issued. Okay, so that is the basic objective. Ministry of Communication is the implementing ministry. Department of Post is the implementing agency. Okay, so that is about the scheme, and total 920 scholarship isme di jayengi, and the amount of scholarship guys is 6000 per annum at rupees 500 per month. Okay, and the selection is guys based on the projects, based on the philately. Okay, and now guys, let's talk about the questions that can be asked in your exams. So you have to read the following passage and answer the questions that follow. A scheme was launched by the Ministry of Communication. All right. So the ministry is given in the year 2017. Launch year is given to promote philately as a hobby, which means three basic things which are required to identify a scheme are already given in this paragraph, which is launch year, ministry, and the basic objective. Under the scheme, government has decided to give 920 scholarship to the students based on their projects on philately, and scholarship is awarded based on the evaluation of project work on the philately. So guys, I think everything is given. You just have to identify the scheme now and mark the answer. So you have to identify the scheme. I hope you can easily identify now. Option A, Sparsh, will be the correct answer. Talking about the question number 2, which agency is the implementing agency? So as we have discussed, the Ministry of Communication is the implementing ministry, and the Ministry of and the Department of Post is the implementing agency, which means option E will be the correct answer to this question. Question number 3 is, what is the amount of scholarship that is being provided? So the amount of scholarship is being asked. So I hope you can easily answer this question. It's rupees 6000 per month per annum at rupees 500 per month. Then we have question number 4. So you have to consider the following statements regarding eligibility. All right. So the students from class 6 to 12th are eligible to get the scholarship. So is it correct? No guys, it is not correct. It's from class 6 to class 9th, which means this statement is incorrect. The student must have scored 60% in the recent final examinations. Yes, this is also correct. And there is a relaxation of 10% in passing marks for SC or ST candidates. This is not 10% guys, this is 5%. So this statement is incorrect, which means we have only one statement that is correct, option number statement number 2, which means option C. Only 2 guys will be the correct answer. All right, and guys, that's it for the scheme Deen Dayal Sparsh Yojana. I hope the scheme is clear. If you have any doubts, you can ask me in the comment section. Milte hain kal ke session mein with a new government scheme. Thank you so much for watching guys. Goodbye, take care, and God bless.